And we've shown you some of the ways that people are pitching in to help in our community.
But one thing almost anyone can do is give the gift of life. Blood donations are critically low. Blood drives have been going on to help alleviate the problem. We even have a blood drive scheduled for tomorrow.
Yeah, that one is by appointment only, and it filled up fast. But the need for blood is and will be an ongoing concern. So we wanted to bring in Deborah Serna, the senior laboratory manager from University Health Systems, to talk about the need for blood and how we can all help, whether there's a blood drive going on or not. Deborah, you've been with UHS for 10 years. You manage blood donor services in the lab there. How great is the need right now? And have you ever seen anything like this before?
Yeah, I've never seen anything like this before in my 10 years here. This is definitely unprecedented. And the need is extremely great. We are short hundreds of units just a day. And so we're monitoring our levels daily and sometimes hourly to make sure we have enough for our patients.
Deborah, you know, we talked about the blood drive that we have with you guys tomorrow. What are some of the safety measures that are going to be in place when folks go in to donate, not just for this drive, but, you know, as, you know, any ones that we have coming down in the future in terms of social distancing and things like that?
Yes, definitely. We want to assure everyone that we're doing everything we can to minimize the risk for spread of the COVID virus. We are doing social distancing. We are utilizing the appointment only. So that's why we ask that we have you make the appointment and keep the appointment so that way we can continue with the donor flow and make sure it doesn't, you know, prevents crowding.
Is there a concern about risks with the coronavirus coming through the blood? I mean, I want to make sure that we are very clear about the fact that there's been no documentation that's how any of this is spread right now.
Correct. We don't have any, there's no evidence that it is spread through blood, but we do ask that our donors be healthy, and that's why we do screen for temperature, physical, and our usual screening processes.
Now, Deborah, O negative, I believe, is the universal blood type. Is that still what's most in need right now, or is there a specific other type of blood type that you're putting out a call for?
We actually need all types, so all types are welcome. Because of the shortage, we've seen across the board all types that we need blood from.
What is the difference between the University Health System and the South Texas Blood and Tissue Center? I mean, we're talking about two different entities here, correct?
Correct. So University Health System, we only collect for our patients here at the hospital, and so we don't send our blood anywhere else. So any blood collected by our donor services is used here in the hospital for our patients. We do collaborate with the South Texas Blood and Tissue Center. So, and especially at this time when blood is really critical low, we ask that you either come to us or definitely visit South Texas Blood and Tissue Center and give it one of their locations there.
Right, because right now the need is so great. You don't really care where people give, just that they give.
Definitely. No, if you're healthy and eligible to donate, please try to help us during this time.
So I gave blood on Sunday, mm-hmm. and some of the questions that I got were people were asking me, if you have diabetes, can you still give?
It depends on the type of medication that you're on for diabetics. And then also if you've donated before, we don't want to cause you to have any health issues by donating.
Now, Deborah, we've been mentioning that the blood shortage is low. A lot of cancellations for blood drives have been happening as we've seen this COVID-19 crisis play out. How big exactly is the drop? Is there a way to quantify that for us?
It's pretty significant just because we usually have units, at least hundreds of units coming in per day that we can utilize. And so a lot of our units are being used. And so if we're in a position where we have a trauma that has to use many units of blood, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. So we want to make sure to get as many donors as we can to make sure their inventory stays at a good level.
And I want to make sure people see you at the bottom of the screen. It's donatebloodtoday.com, 210-358-2812 for more information. Is there anything that you would say to somebody who's on the fence about giving blood or who's maybe never given blood before in their life? What would you tell them?
Well, definitely now is the time. Even if you just try to donate. Not everyone can donate because of health reasons or maybe even travel, but at this time is the best time to come in and at least try. And we're asking people just to get up the courage. I know it can be a little bit scary, but we're definitely in need of it right now, if any.
Yeah, and just because we're full tomorrow does not mean that you can't give at other locations within the University Health System or South Texas Blood and Tissue Center. Wherever you give, they're very grateful that it happens. Deborah Serna, thank you. And by the way, if you have questions about giving blood or the blood supply or what happens, Deborah's going to be back and joining us online at KSAT News at 9, and she's going to be taking viewer questions. So if you go to our website in our SAQ section, we would love to get your questions or send them to our email, call our desk. They love when I say that. Call our desk and questions that you have about giving blood. But tonight, during the 9 o'clock news, we will answer some of your questions.
All right, we'll be right back.